I'm a lonely Goomba, stuck between two pipes. Well, guess I keep on gaming for the rest of my life.
You know, over the years, I've ripped into a lot of games. I mean, don't get me wrong, some of those games really did suck. But still, I'm feeling good today. Happy even. Well, maybe I wouldn't go that far, but still, I think it's time we do something positive. Lift our spirits, you know? There's enough crap going on that I think we could do without some crappy games for a while. So, today, we're gonna be changing up a bit. We're gonna be talking about, perhaps, the best original Game Boy game. But what is it? Is it Link's Awakening? I mean, that is pretty good. But no. Wario Land, again, pretty good. And that guy does have a knife, that's pretty cool. But no. Well, get on with it then, what is it? Well, I'm talking about Donkey Kong, the forgotten gem of the Game Boy. Now, at a glance, you might be thinking, yo, Gooms, this is just a port of an arcade game, right? You're talking nonsense, mate. And I don't blame you for thinking that. But you're wrong, as per usual. So let's take a look, shall we? Oh, and for the sake of the video, I'm going to be showing the game played on the Super Game Boy because it has some colour and a nice little border. It's pretty neat, eh? Now the game, and it does start off like the standard arcade game. You play through the original stages, you climb up, you dodge some pies, and you beat DK, and that's it. It's the arcade game. Only, no, the game just trolled you. Donkey Kong is fine, and he takes Pauline, and legs it. And guess what? There's 97 more stages to go. 97 more stages of Donkey Kong goodness. Donkey Kong simply does not quit in this version. You chase him through New Donk City, a forest, a pirate ship, a jungle, a desert, an airplane, an iceberg, a rocky valley, and finally, a tower. Imagine running around the world just to be with a lass who doesn't even like you. Donkey Kong is the ultimate simp. But besides the countless locations, what makes this game so different from, say, the original? Well, a few things. To demonstrate, here is a comparison between the standard Donkey Kong arcade game and Donkey Kong on the Game Boy. You see that shit? Oh boy. Keep in mind, this game released 2 years before Mario 64. You got Mario backflipping, hand standing, high jumping, rolling, heck, you could even spin off wires and go flying. Mario is one athletic bugger in this game. There's just so much stuff, and the game is constantly introducing new mechanics too, usually explained with these little cutscenes between worlds. Always a pleasure to watch these things, and it's a great way to show players how to play, as opposed to overly long tutorials, you know? So the game, and it does start off quite simple. See, the game basically has three types of levels: puzzles, action, and bosses. The first and most common are the puzzle stages. See, instead of just reaching Donkey Kong to progress, you need to find the key and carry it to the door. Simple enough, right? But man, these levels really do start to get quite complicated. A few worlds in, you'll find yourself having to flick switches, control platforms, heck, you even have to manipulate enemy positions in order to use them as platforms, or say, use a fire enemy to melt ice. And in some cases, you grab onto their little monkey tails. Oh man, look at them go. I mean, that's gotta hurt. I feel kinda bad actually. Mario really does have an irrational hatred for primates, don't he? Later on in the game, it introduces perhaps the biggest new mechanic, the ability to create ladders and platforms, which just really opens up even more puzzle aspects, especially when you consider they can only exist for a short time. Heck, this level basically has you create the entire stage from scratch. Not gonna lie, I remember this taking me forever as a kid. It was way too hard for my little brain, although I do wish the timer music was a bit less incredibly annoying. I mean, you gotta listen to this tune a lot. It's a bit annoying, right, isn't it? But onto the second set of levels, which I like to call action stages, which are basically new stages in the style of the original arcade game. Yeah, get to the top, dodge Donkey Kong's attacks, and try to rescue Pauline. So if you ever just wanted more classic arcade Donkey Kong stages, this game has you covered. And like the puzzle stages, these keep getting more elaborate as we go on. I mean, this one has moving platforms, cannons, levers, and there's wind blowing you off the platform. Jeez, give me a break. And oddly enough, one of these stages is a stage straight from Donkey Kong Jr. That's pretty neat. You know, whilst we're on the topic of Donkey Kong Jr., something pretty interesting about this game is how it incorporates so much from the previous titles. Obviously, you have the original arcade game as the base, but as the game progresses, it shifts more towards Donkey Kong Jr. The climbing mechanics especially play a big role. Heck, like I mentioned, some of the stages are ripped right from it. Unlike previous Donkey Kong games though, as the game goes on, Jr. starts to interfere with the actual stages more. Yeah, just see him hanging out causing all sorts of trouble. Little Gippy throwing poison mushrooms at me, there's no way around it. Jr. wants Mario dead. Can't really blame him though, can you? But all that trouble just makes it all the sweeter when we eventually get to lock the bugger up. That's right, in a cruel twist of irony, instead of using the keys to rescue Donkey Kong like from the arcade game, we're using the same keys to lock up Junior. Is Mario a bad person? Donkey Kong doesn't seem to care though. They're more concerned with Pauline, you know? Just leaves Junior there to die. Even Mario has to do a double take. Parent of the Year award right there, eh chaps? I mean, Donkey Kong really needs to learn a lesson in bros before hoes. Or, you know, his son before hoes. But finally, onto the third type of level, also known as boss fights. There's no puzzles here, you just gotta beat the crap out of DK. I mean really though, he had it coming. Usually the fights go like this. You dodge barrels or falling objects and then you wait for a barrel to land, and you pick it up and you throw it at DK. Sometimes it changes things up a bit, but it's usually mostly the same. Sometimes you might be throwing an Egyptian head at him, for instance, and sometimes you got birds pooping eggs. But the objective always remains the same. Give DK a taste of his own medicine. So, after playing through the game and beating up Donkey Kong more times than I can remember, we make it to the final world. The tower. A little cool detail is how you can see the tower in the background of a previous world, and as you progress through the world, it gets closer and closer until you're literally right outside it. I like little details like that. But yeah, the final world. And things change up actually. There's no puzzle levels here. Nope, each level, you just have to get to the top and reach Donkey Kong. And the higher up you get, the more intense the music gets. You know, it starts off pretty foreboding, but before you know it, things get serious. I mean, just listen to this music. And man, the final level is pretty hard. It basically puts everything you've learned to the test. You got mushrooms to dodge, you got platforms too high up to reach without special jumps, and to top it all off, the frickin' floor is disintegrating under your feet. And if you get hit once, you're basically dead. Like me, give me a break. But we make it to the final battle, and man, the music is even more intense. This is like, why is this music so good? You know what, let's just take a listen. Who knew that a Game Boy could handle a guitar solo so well? Giving Metallica a run for its money there, jeez. The fight itself though, and it's not that hard. In fact, it's really easy. And that's it. Yeah, finally get to cheat on Princess Peach, and Donkey Kong falls to his bloody death. Only, wait. The giant DK head on the world map is smiling. That can't be good. Only evil people smile. And suddenly, a bunch of mushrooms start flying up, and a giant DK emerges. This is it, the true final boss. And man, I'm not gonna lie, this isn't easy. Not only is the boss long with three different segments, you can only get hit once. I'm not ashamed to say, this took me a few tries. The trick is to jump on his hands and get up on these platforms. The issue being, each slam of his fist will knock you down if you're not in the air. And when he does shit like this, it's easier said than done. Seriously, I cannot remember the last time a Nintendo game got my heart beating this fast. It's intense. And whilst I do get some pleasure of seeing Mario squish like a pancake, it's time to finish this. And whammo, he's dead. For real this time. And as a nice little nod to the Mario series, we go home. Pauline gives Mario a super mushroom, and suddenly he's ungodly big. Like, way too big, it looks silly. No wonder Mario has so many women after him. And Donkey Kong sort of just stands there and looks slightly embarrassed, and then the credits roll. You know, Mario's pretty quick to forgive Donkey Kong, I guess, but that's it. Donkey Kong on the Game Boy. And hopefully I did this game some justice, but you know, you can always play it for yourself. And, as I'm sure some of you have been thinking the entire video, yes, they did do a sequel to this game, Mario vs. Donkey Kong. And if this video does well enough, I shall be looking into that next time and seeing how well it compares to this. But for now, have a good one, and bye! And the patron of the week is, who else but Zane? But I mean, with a username like that, who else could it be if not Zane? Bob? I mean, it ain't gonna be Bob, is it? Let's be real. Sorry, Bob, but no one likes you.